So, let me share with you the lessons and the subjects we'll be talking about in this class, these next four lessons. So we have lesson 9 on romantic rejection, when we have experienced the pain of, at least in our perception, having being rejected, which is not usually the case. It's just that other people have other issues, other needs. And some of the subjects discussed in that lesson, number 9 on romantic rejection, the pain of romantic rejection by separation or divorce. There's another lesson, number 20, in which we discuss the loss of a loved one when the loved one leaves the physical body. Now we're talking about when the loved one is in the body and we're separated. Possible emotions that we might need to work on. Alternative positive perceptions that free us from the negative emotions, the pain, the rejection, the hurt, the anger, maybe the guilt. How we may have participated in that breakup so that we don't create the same situation in the future. Lessons we can learn through such an experience. How can we, what can we gain once it's done? I'm all for staying in relationships and growing and working through them. But when it happens and we can't change it, how can we benefit from that? And we then employ combined techniques for transcending this painful experience. Now, lesson 10 is dealing with injustice. We talk about the types of injustice, possible emotions when we experience injustice. It's injustice, but pain, hurt, sometimes guilt, fear. Expressing our needs and establishing boundaries, one aspect of dealing with injustice is not allowing it to happen. What's happened has happened. We have to work through accepting that, but we may have need to learn how to prevent that from now on and how to establish boundaries. And there will be another lesson on this, not in this group of lessons, but later on in the self-knowledge seminar. Why injustice takes place? What are the causes of it? How we attract injustice, a very important issue, alternative perceptions that free us from pain, and alternative perceptions that enable us to establish boundaries, and then we employ the methods for getting free. Now, this is class number 3, which means that to benefit from this, you will have to have done the first 8 lessons, class 1, first 4 lessons, class 2, second lessons 5 to 8, and this class, which is lessons 9 to 12, okay? And the 11th lesson, a list of possible negative annoying behaviors, dealing with negativity. I don't like the word negative people because people are expressions of the divine, but they can have negative attitudes, negative ways of dealing with things, of speaking, of behaving. So what do we do with this negativity? Why they behave that way? And most importantly of all, why we are affected by how they behave. Why do they behave that way and why are we affected? Truths that can set us free. And then we employ the method TAT for the first time in this series of lessons for freeing ourselves from attracting and being affected by their behaviors. We are going to use TAT in further lessons for forgiving others and forgiving ourselves. And the last lesson in this group, in this class number 3, is the Healing Code by Alex Lloyd and the 12 qualities of our higher nature. Now, this is how Alex Lloyd has created the Healing Code, but I have added to that the 12 qualities of our higher nature, how it works, how it can be used, communication with the subconscious, positive perceptions, and the 12 qualities of our higher nature, and employing the Healing Code on an issue that obstructs our peace, happiness, or love, or our health, okay? And so that is what is involved in this class, lessons 9 to 12. Hope you enjoy them. Be well.